I'm on my great escape, my very own culinary adventure across India.
I've been in love with Indian food ever since I grew up. Ever since I remember my mum cooking her first curry. Very good.
Fucking spicy.
It's not just me, it's the nation's favourite dish.
I've already been to the north, where I discovered the origins of our curry house classics.
That's it?
Yeah.
So the chutney's made out of ants? Yeah. They're everywhere!
Now, I'm heading off on an adventure into the wilds of India.
It's okay, you come out alive, don't worry.
I come out alive, yeah. I'm still shitting myself.
I want to uncover India's hidden gastronomic gems.
Wow, look at that.
Black pudding. Who'd ever believe we're in India? No spice.
Oh, show me the cover! I'll turn you up!
And try my discoveries out in India's ultimate foodie city.
Here we go!
First service of Mr. Gordon.
Yes!
Yes!
Tonight, I'm on the second leg of my Indian great escape, learning how to cook my favourite food, curry. And now I'm heading off the beaten track to discover India's best-kept culinary secrets.
In a way, I'm looking for sort of the unheard-of, authentic Indian food, and something that's never been seen on any menu, Indian menu, anywhere in the UK. Food and dishes that we've never even read about.
So, for the next week, I'm leaving the tourist trail behind and going on an adventure into the far reaches of northeast India. Bordered by China and Burma, this region is remote and inaccessible. But I'm told the mouth-watering curries will be worth it. They're made with ingredients unavailable anywhere else in India.
I'm heading out, really out into the northeast tip of India, almost out into the wild, so, yeah.
Before I get there, I'm stopping off in Calcutta. This is my gateway to the northeast, and it will be the last bit of civilization I see for a while. This faded beauty was once the British colonial capital of India. Now it's a hectic metropolis and all the action happens out here on the streets.
One cup of tea, please.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, it's nice.
There are 135,000 stalls here and I hear it's the best street food in India.
What is it? Potato? Very good. In fact, it's delicious.
Ah, fucking spicy.
I can't believe the variety on offer.
Egg sandwiches. Calcutta's very own pret a manger. Fascinating. Are they noodles?
Yeah, noodles.
This noodles. So it's chicken, noodles, vegetable, chili sauce, with a bit of tomato sauce on there. Very good.
And everything is prepared from scratch right here on the street.
Just the level of the basic food on this street is of a delicious nature. And you've got like this gourmet trail starting from the back, like a little, you know, canapé with the eggs, and then you go down to the vegetable, then all of a sudden you hit the meat right at the very end, and then finish with the desserts. There's not a street like it anywhere in the world.
But right now, I've got someone to meet just around the corner in Calcutta's business district.
He's typing.
He's typing.
Typing.
Court matter.
No email.
Pardon?
Email, no. No, no. Oh, no. Okay. Happy typing.
Hi, Gordon.
I'm London.
How are you?
Yeah, I spotted you.
At long last.
Welcome to Chaotic Calcutta.
Thank you so much. Good to see you.
Seasoned foodie Nandan Bachchu is one of the few food writers to have ventured into the impenetrable northeast, and he's agreed to give me the lowdown on where to go.
What brings you here, Gordon?
I'm heading off into the northeast, and you seem to be the only person that sort of understands exactly what I can gain from there.
Well, it will be a completely different experience from any other food available on the subcontinent.
Really?
Yeah.
So not like the north,
no.
Not like Basta.
Not at all.
Nothing
not
like
at
that.
All. Nothing to do with your chicken tikka culture, which
Korma.
Is North Indian kormas, Punjabi food, biryanis. Nothing of the sort whatsoever.
Why?
It's mainly a tribal culture.
Right.
And people live off the earth. It's very peasant food. It's wild country. There's a lot of hunting going on for
yep.
food. Except for tables and chairs, they eat anything with four legs.
Except tables and chairs, they'll eat anything with four legs?
Yeah.
Jesus.
So,
really?
Be prepared.
Oh, Christ.
It's a very exciting cuisine. You better be ready for some hot food because famous for chilies.
Oh, really?
Not known outside the northeast much.
So I can't find any of the food from northeast here on this street?
No.
No.
No, no.
Why not?
I think mainly because it's so different.
Right.
And it's unfamiliar to the taste buds.
Right. Maybe here would be quite intriguing to bring back an influence from northeast.
Yes.
And to put it on the streets here.
Yeah, and believe me, it'll be the first time anybody has done that kind of thing here.
Right.
I'd love to be the first person to introduce the food of the northeast to this foodie mecca.
I'll see you in a week's time,
yeah?
Fingers crossed.
Okay.
Tomorrow, I'll be travelling to Nagaland, one of the most remote regions in India. I have a feeling home comforts will be thin on the ground, and so tonight, I'm making the most of what Calcutta has to offer.
Bed. Oh, Jesus. Trust me, when you get a chance to take advantage of some luxury, you lap it up, because only God knows where I'm going to be sleeping tomorrow night.
The next day, I'm on a flight from Calcutta, travelling 900 kilometres to Dibrugarh in Assam. I'm heading to Nagaland. I'll be staying with a local tribe that have a reputation for the hunting prowess and their fantastic game curries. I just hope the natives are friendly, as I'll be the first Western chef they've ever met.
Good to see you. Grits on. Gordon is G-O-R-D-O-N. G-O-R-D-O-N.
From Dibrugarh, I've now got a 150-kilometre road trip to make through Assam before I even get to the Nagaland border.
4 hours to go on roads like this. Look, Jeremy Clarkson, eat your heart out. Look, no-handed, on the telephone. I'll change gear if you want.
Nagaland has a reputation for being a dangerous place for Westerners to travel alone.
Slow down, this looks like the border crossing. Please. Stop, Nagaland, please. Checkpost. Okay.
I'm being met by Fajin. She's the only English speaker from the village where I'm staying.
Tell me you're a friend of Nandan's.
Yes.
How are you, my darling? Good to see
Hello.
You. What
Hello.
A journey.
Okay. Oh. Welcome to Nagaland.
Thank you very much indeed.
I have a necklace for you to welcome to Nagaland.
Jesus.
This is a skull necklace.
A skull necklace?
Yes, yeah.
It looks like a massive doorknob. So what, yeah. What is that?
We are headhunters from our tribe.
Hold on a minute. You used to be or you are?
We used to be headhunters. Don't worry.
No, I'm not worrying. I'm shitting myself.
If you're good, then I won't take your head.
Jesus, if you're good, I won't take your head off. Sound like my wife. Goodbye.
So have you ever traveled to any part of the world like this?
I have never been to such remote areas
good.
Of any part of the world like this.
Good.
Ever.
It's okay, you come out alive. Don't worry.
I come out alive, yeah. I'm still shitting myself. Problem with the brakes, no?
Motorways just don't exist here. And the endless bumpy roads are getting to me.
Surely we must be near. Two hours, 45 minutes after crossing the border.
Welcome to Siong Village.
Over 1,000 kilometers after leaving Calcutta, we're finally here. I really need a warm welcome.
This is it. Bloody hell. Oh, my God.
Welcome to my house.
Thank you very much.
I'm on a culinary adventure through India, and I've travelled into the wilds of the northeast, where I'm on the trail of India's best-kept culinary secrets. I've just arrived in Nagaland, where I'll be staying with the Konyak tribe, and I'm the first Western chef they've ever met.
Oh, my God. Hello.
This is my father. Gordon.
Sir, how are you? Your father's name? What do I call him?
Mr. Honley.
Mr. Honley.
Yeah.
He looks like a chief.
And this is my mother.
How are you?
Maidong, she's fine.
Nice to see you.
This is a warrior shawl.
It's a warrior shawl.
From my parents.
It's very kind. Thank you very much. Oh, shit. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That's amazing. Who are all these people here?
These are our relatives and villagers.
Quick, say hello. Hello, hello.
Hello.
Hello, hello. Oh, shit. What is that?
It's all...
This is all boar?
Yeah, pork, smoked pork.
And what are these bits here?
These are...
Intestines?
Intestine.
And we eat them as well?
Yes, it's not now.
Gee, I thought that was only Hannibal Lecter who had that.
The tribe might actually enjoy meat more than I do. Ferjian's father has even got a version of one of my favourites on the go.
So it's like a blood sausage, like black pudding?
Yes.
Inside the bamboo?
Yes.
Wow, look at that. Black pudding. That is delicious. That is very good.
Very good.
We don't put chili in our blood sausage black pudding back in the UK.
We use chili for everything.
You think of any authentic Indian food, you never ever think about black pudding, but that's just completely different. Thank you. And a great cup of tea as well. Fucking hell. This is how we eat in Scotland. You know, black pudding, and tea.
He said that because he's good looking and handsome, like he has got 3 wives.
So, oh Jesus!
What about you?
No. Yeah, those laws don't apply in Wandsworth. The News of the World would love that one.
He said, "Why don't you come with him tomorrow for the hunt?"
I would love to go hunting.
He is inviting you.
Okay. I thought it was banned.
No. This is tribal land. We are the owners of our land. Right. And we have every right to hunt.
To hunt. Them.
Yes.
And that's how the village survives.
Yes.
To think that 50, 60 years ago, there was tribal gangs, warfare, revenge, and the only way to seek revenge was beheaded your victim. And that's not fucking about now. I mean, that's pretty, So they all may look nice and smiley and high fives and how you doing? Sit down, have some black pudding and a cup of tea. But you wouldn't want to fuck with them in the jungle, would you?
After last night's welcoming ceremony, I'm keen to get stuck in. This morning, I'm watching the hunt. The trophies on show are testament to this village's long history of living off the land. Fijin's grandfather is the most experienced hunter in the village, and I would like an introduction.
You read about these guys and you hear about them at school in RE and things like that, but fucking hell. You'd never ever believe you had the chance to sit and eat breakfast with them. Right. Excellent. Good morning, sir. Good morning. How are you? Now, he's got five skulls on there. I've got four on mine. Well, what's the difference?
Only the men that they have taken the
heads off
wear this.
And he's taken two heads off in his time.
Yes.
I better let him eat his breakfast before he takes mine off.
He's laughing.
Before the hunt starts, I've been asked to join some of the villagers for a special ceremony.
Before we go for a hunt,
yes,
we will sacrifice a chicken.
So you slit its throat, you cut it through its mouth.
With the chicken's blood, we smear all the guns or whatever type of weapon we're taking for a hunt. We do this as a ritual just to be one with nature, like.
Okay. Okay, great. Why is he just pulling the intestine out?
We will check whether our hunt will be successful or not. If there's blood on this side, see inside, then there will be injury. But there's no blood today, so there's no.
So it's a safe hunt.
Yeah, it's safe hunt.
Thanks for that. Wahoo! Whoa!
The size may have been good, but with the entire village ready for battle, I'm not taking any risks.
Tell them all now, if you recognise the blue T-shirt, don't fucking shoot, OK? A wife and four kids to feed. Are you a good shot?
Yes.
Yeah.
Today, they'll be tracking boar or deer in the forest, as it's going to be turned into tonight's supper by Fijin's father. I've got a vested interest in this hunt going well.
So when we get into the forest, we're going to split into two groups and circle around the hunt.
We will split into different groups. Gordon, just be careful with the machine.
Yeah. So how are we going to find the other hunters?
They are only waiting for the sound of the hunting dogs, and when they hear, then they will also just run.
So we just sit and wait for the noises?
He asked, what do you do for a living?
What do I do for a living?
In London.
I'm a cook.
And
he's a cook in the main meeting.
He says he's also a chef.
He's a chef as well.
He cooked in our food. Say, how much money do you earn in 1 week for the cooking?
Oh, shit. That's a good question. I mean, from £1,000 a week to £10,000 a week. Yeah, I'm just going to... Go on.
He said, my father will come... my father said he will come back with you to London for cooking.
Maybe tonight... we can both cook together for the village.
Yeah, he said he's ready.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Dinner's on me.
Thankfully, the hunt seems to be hotting up, which has saved me from any more embarrassing questions.
Jeez.
It's Gordon Ramble.
Shit, I missed the fucking machete.
Did you hurt yourself?
I missed with the fucking machete.
Oh,
it's
shit.
Fine. It's fine. Honestly, absolutely fine. It's fine. It's fine.
I know we're looking for first blood, but it's not meant to be mine.
Yeah, and so I was hacking back.
Yeah.
And it sort of bounced back, and I think it was the corner.
Yes, yes.
That went in. Yeah. The chicken said no injuries on the hunt. Okay, good. So they found something, but not too sure what it is. Jesus Christ, there's guns going off everywhere. Huh? He's happy! Jesus, it's a fucking pigeon. All that for that. There's more than that in there, surely.
That's not going to feed a hungry hunting party.
Shit.
But it isn't all over yet.
Fuck. Where's the deer?
Deer, the deer is there.
Here's the deer.
Oh, hey.
This looks better. So we've got a deer. It's not a wild boar. I started to shit myself. They were celebrating over a little 4-ounce pigeon.
The whole village turns out to welcome its brave hunters. These good old boys know how to party.
Who gets the head?
The right thigh, and the head goes to the chief.
Right thigh?
Yeah, yeah.
Who's that bit for? The guy who shot it. Congratulations.
He shot.
Well done. Great shot.
Aqua Champa, since you are our guest,
yes.
We will give this chunk of meat.
I've got that chunk.
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Fascinating, they never skin it first. They just hack through it, and the head straight off. I feel very honoured to be given half a saddle of deer, especially when I did jack shit this morning to catch it, except put an axe through my fucking foot. What a knob. Right, let's get clean.
Now for the real reason I'm here. I'm going to see what makes a Nagaland curry so different to anything I've ever tasted before. As I've been gifted the venison, Mr. Honley is going to create a curry using the boar that he slaughtered.
So, in the...
A kidney.
Kidney.
Heart. In the flesh.
Heart, kidney, liver.
Liver. And belly.
Are you cooking everything at the same time? See, normally, we'd cook this separately.
It's very rustic. Do you mean nothing's filleted, nothing's ever off the bone? And what's that Dad's putting there now?
My father is putting another kind of leaf which we find in the forest.
And what's it like? Thank you. It's quite citrusy, no?
Yeah, yeah.
It's like lavender.
We use even the fruits for really? Spice, like pepper.
Everything Mr. Honley is using in his dish comes from his own land. This is the first Indian curry I've seen made without any dried spices.
What's Dad doing with the chilies?
He's roasting it. We have a better flavoring if we roast it on the ash like that.
Yeah.
It gives a better scent.
Yeah, well, we do the same with peppers.
And the most surprising ingredient is something I've never seen before. It's bamboo shoot.
Yeah, that's a fascinating smell, that, you know that? Slightly spicy. edge to it.
While the pork and the bamboo curry cooks, I'm going to try out these Nagaland ingredients with my saddle of venison to see what I can come up with.
Pure fillet. Just a little touch. They intrigue me, the flavour there, you know that.
How do you turn up the gas?
Thank you. How many Westerners have come and cook in this kitchen?
None.
No. I'm the first.
Huh? Mmm. It's a tradition in Scotland. We always have a swig each. Oh, yes.
Linguja, linguja.
It means our passion is joined with the dish.
Okay. While my venison curry reduces, Mr. Honley's pork and bamboo curry is already done, and I can't wait to taste it.
The pork is delicious. Very tasty, the chilli, the garlic. And it looked quite sort of boring and greasy. But flavour-wise, delicious. That's delicious, the pork.
The villagers from today's hunt that didn't get a cut of the deer came to share mine.
Very nice.
Happy?
Yes. Jordan?
Yep.
Can you just give them a second helping?
Of course.
There's real community spirit here, and it makes eating together all that more enjoyable.
Goodbye, father. Goodbye, sister. If I don't see you in this
mood. The pork dish I tasted of theirs was amazing. You'd think that there was 15 different spices. The dried bamboo, in terms of flavour, it's intense. Yeah, it has an intriguing sort of turnip stroke, cardamom, sort of slightly spicy edge to it. Who'd ever believe we're in India? No spice, no turmeric, yeah, no coriander, no cinnamon, no cloves. Everything's just, yeah, from the ground. It's quite interesting, you dive into their world and you get rid of that monkey on your back and all of a sudden you start to relax in a big way and forget anything outside this village.
I came in search of India's best-kept culinary secrets, and Nagaland didn't disappoint. I've had my first taste of this region's indigenous ingredients, and I can't wait to see what other surprises the Northeast has in store.
Thank you very much. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.
Made me feel so special. Okay. Best wishes. Thank you, my darling.
Okay.
Take care. Upwards and onwards.
And I've taken a bit of Nagaland with me. I want to use the bamboo shoot on my food stall when I get back to Calcutta.
Extraordinary. Different and incredibly rustic. Very humble, very simple, but fascinating food, though. Totally unspoilt. And in a way, nothing Indian.
I'm now heading back into the state of Assam on my way to Majuli. It's an island in the middle of the Brahmaputra River where fish is plentiful and the locals make an amazing fish curry. But first, I'm stopping off in Jorat.
There's an event going on today by some crazy lady who's attempting to stick over 60 chilies in her mouth within 2 minutes and eat them. And then she wants to go on and rub more in her eyes. Can we make this on the way to Majuli? We won't miss the ferry. I've got to see it. Yeah? OK. I mean, is she nuts? Unreal. Let's go.
More chilies are eaten in the northeast of India than anywhere else in the world, and Assam produces the hottest on Earth.
Excuse me.
Mum of one, Amandita Tamoli, has a massive appetite for them. Today, she's attempted to break her own world record for eating 60 whole chilies in 2 minutes.
May I taste, please? Yep.
This is no ordinary chili. And Nandita will be munching on the boot de luckia.
Yeah. The whole thing. Or...
But don't eat it.
Don't eat it.
For have...
Just take one.
He's taking that to have a bite, but not to eat it, not to chew it. It'll be very hot.
This baby is 200 times hotter than a jalapeno. It's a chili nuclear bomb.
That's very hot.
Yeah. One is enough.
It's very, very hot indeed. My mouth's still burning on a little piece of one. Are you mad? No. Okay. Good luck.
So here we go.
Yeah. I'm playing safe by being timekeeper.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Seconds gone.
Oh my God.
1 minute gone. Shit. Excuse me. 2 minutes dead! Stop! Oh, Jesus. Is she gonna be sick? Get some water for the lady, quickly. Oh, my God. How many's left?
19 is here.
So it's 49, so it's 11 off the record. Unfortunately, 49.
51 over the countdown.
You okay? Don't cry, don't cry. Is she okay? Don't get upset over a chili.
Down but not out. And Nandita has decided to up the ante. She's going to try to rub more than 12 chilies in her eyes in under 1 minute.
How many is that? 30. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Fifteen seconds gone. Come on, you lot, wake up! Seconds gone. Come on! 15 seconds to go! You only got 6 left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And stop! Excellent.
Fantastic!
You okay? We started off with 30.
24!
She's broken the record. The world record! 24 chilies! Excellent. Congratulations. Well done. Really well done. I think you are mad. Excellent. I mean, those chilies were extraordinary hot. I mean, unbelievably hot. Just biting into one, it just sort of exploded and all of a sudden your mouth went on fire, but it's a very bizarre thing to witness. She's off a trolley. A confirmed nut.
I'm on a culinary adventure in the northeast of India, travelling through the most remote parts of the country and tracking down dishes that can't be found anywhere else. I'm now leaving the Assamese city of Jorhat to travel 20 kilometres along the Brahmaputra River to the island of Majuli.
2-hour ferry ride to Majuli. Peace and quiet now. There's something quite addictive to a fast pace. Fast life, but it's also nice just to slow down.
Majuli is the largest river island in the world, and for 5 months during the monsoon, it's almost entirely underwater. Freshwater fish are plentiful, and so there's no better place to find a delicious traditional fish curry. I'm here to meet one of Assam's most celebrated chefs, Atul Laka. He runs two restaurants, and he's agreed to show me one of his classic fish curries.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. We start for fishing.
Pissing?
Fishing.
Oh, fishing.
Yes, okay. You like fishing?
I love fishing.
Yeah, because people of Assam, we like fishing.
Yep.
Let's hope Atul's cooking is better than his English.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready, ready. You move.
Wait for me.
Yeah. Come.
But, yeah, but the brakes don't work on mine.
Yeah, this is my place. That's why I was...
150,000 islanders live here, and they survive almost entirely on a diet of fish, and all of it comes from these freshwater ponds.
99% of the village live on fish.
Yes, fish.
Wow. Jesus Christ, that boat's not going to put up with a fat bastard like me, I tell you. Huh?
You have to balance.
Yeah, I'm trying. Wee.
That's great.
Well, that was a shit start, wasn't it? See, I knew it wouldn't take 15 seconds. Sorry, guys. Will you apologize for me?
To God, and you were so heavy.
You're a lot lighter than I am. Look how skinny these guys are.
Yeah. It's great.
They're not even 60 kilos. Jesus. He's so light.
Yeah.
These flimsy boats can't take a culinary heavyweight like me, so on to plan B.
Well, we've got some more fish from the market.
We've bought some fish, and now Atul's going to cook denga, a traditional Assamese fish curry that has a truly unique flavour.
And what's that called?
It's the elephant apple.
Uh-huh. And what do they taste like, apples?
It's like chowa.
Chowa?
Yeah, it's good.
So they're acidic?
Yeah.
It's this tropical fruit that gives denga its signature sour flavour, which will add bite to the earthy taste of our freshwater fish.
So where's the recipe from?
Everywhere in Assam, people use this type of fish, this curry.
Okay.
Green chili.
Very good. But no spices?
No, only chili they use.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Our chili is so special.
Yep.
So I noticed the varieties of chili.
Right.
You know, poor chili, you know that is the hottest chili in the world.
Yes.
So I add a little bit of chowd.
Yep.
Garlic.
What have you got in there? What have you put in?
A little bit of turmeric.
Turmeric. Excellent. Good. And is that you done then?
Yeah. My curry's finished.
Your curry's finished. Curry in a hurry.
You like my traditional Assamese food?
The curry's delicious. And you've managed to make it with no spices.
Yeah.
So I totally understand where you're coming from. It's been really good, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, just before I go, I want you to say one thing for me. Fishing.
Fishing.
Snake.
Snack. No, it's not good.
No. Snake.
Snack.
On my trip, I've realized that the curry we know and love in the UK is really a narrow selection of the amazing dishes India has to offer. I've discovered new ingredients with unusual flavors like elephant apple and bamboo shoot, and tasted the hottest chili in the world.
The Northeast is very special, and it's sort of the opposite to what I expected, because, you know, there's no garam masala, you know, there's no powders. It's all fresh, fragrant, very little spice. Fascinating food, though, totally unspoilt.
Now I'm leaving the wilderness behind and travelling nearly 350 kilometres to Guwahati. This Assamese city is expanding fast, but the locals still hold tight to tradition. And one in particular is very close to my own heart. Home cooking. Every year, a competition is held to find the best Assamese dish in the region. And it's happening here today. 40 cooks battle it out for the title. I'm going to enter, but in order to rub shoulders with the best cooks in Assam, I need a winning recipe. So I've wangled an inn with a local domestic goddess.
Atul suggested that I spend some time with these misses. She's going to show me exactly how she cooks. If there's one way of going back to Calcutta with some really exciting, stunning dishes, it's going to be from this competition. Yes. Hello, Rashmi,
hello.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Finally.
Okay.
This is a first for me, entering a domestic competition.
Actually, today I'm going to show you how to cook chicken with sesame seed.
Chicken with sesame seed?
Yes.
And who taught you this dish?
Yeah, I just learned it from my mother, from my granny. I always do my cooking at home because Atul, he doesn't like to cook at home. He's better in his restaurant.
He's like me.
Oh, sure.
Do you know why? Because we haven't got the staff at home.
Oh.
Get that nice and hot.
This is the mustard oil.
Oh, yeah. Christ, that is.
Does it smell?
It's nice.
Oh,
yeah.
We never use refined oil. What we prefer is the mustard oil.
Right, and that's the flavour.
Yeah, we prefer less oil.
I feel like I'm back at school with my home economic teacher.
Oh,
you know that?
Do I look like a teacher?
Yeah.
Why?
Oh. Yeah, young and sexy.
Oh, cool, cool.
Wow. So onions, garlic in.
Chilies.
So you put them in whole?
Yeah, yeah.
All the chicken in? It's quite dry, but...
We don't use too much of oil.
That's why you're very slim and beautiful.
Uh-huh.
He's a lucky man, Atul.
Thank you. I do lots of yoga, you know.
Yoga?
Yoga.
Oh, too boring for me, yoga.
Rashmi's healthy family recipe then uses fresh turmeric and coriander.
The colour has to remain green, so it's a green curry. You can
Jesus,
see.
This is a housewife competition. You're so serious and so strict.
Uh-huh.
It will remain green.
Yes.
I promise.
Yeah.
That smells delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Colour looks amazing.
Yes.
I don't recognise the final ingredient. It's black sesame seed paste, and it's only used in northeast Indian curries.
Okay, good.
It's very tempting, isn't it?
It is delicious. Very tempting.
It is delicious.
And it looks fantastic.
Yes. Yeah. Are you hungry?
I am a little bit. I don't like to eat before I go into competitions.
Oh, you are very nervous.
So, nervous energy, yes.
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 That's the real point, you know? Since you are nervous, you don't want to eat.
I'm going to have a little taste. Yeah, it's very good.
Everything is perfect.
Yeah.
Everything.
I'm not going to say done, I'm going to say chef. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. You're most welcome.
That is delicious. Fingers crossed.
I think Atul's missus might actually be a better cook than he is.
So this is a token of love for me.
Ooh.
And just you're going to win it. It's a good luck. Okay?
3 tablespoons of garlic, ginger. Coriander paste, sesame seed paste at the end, at the end. Hello. Jesus.
The best dish in Assam is a much sought after title.
So, pardon?
Yes, I'm here to, yeah. I'm here to cook.
All of us.
Thank you very much indeed. Amazing.
My 40 fellow competitors have been perfecting the recipes for months, but I want to give them a run for their money.
Ready, steady, we start.
Ready, steady, we start. Oh, shit.
I'm feeling pretty confident. I just need to remember what goes in first.
Little smell, darling. Little smell.
Yeah,
not too much garlic. No?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Right, lid on. Keep an eye on that for me, please. Yeah?
And just turn down the gas a little bit and have a little wander.
While that reduces, I'm sneaking off to spy on the competition.
And this one is?
Pigeon.
Pigeon. Mmm, yeah. That smells nice, that. What's this one here?
This is opium.
Opium?
Yeah.
Shit. Opium? Poppy seeds.
Poppy seeds.
And this is?
Chicken.
Chicken. Oh, I'm doing chicken as well.
Yeah.
What else have you got in there? Onions, chicken. Garlic.
Onion, garlic, and ginger.
So everyone's doing a little bit of decoration, aren't they?
No.
Is that for your decoration?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, right. I better get my arse into gear and do some decoration.
This lot might look like India's answer to the WI, but they're actually pretty good cooks.
They're now garnishing the dishes. It's gone up a notch. Bloody hell, this started out as a sort of domestic, sort of, yeah, local competition. They know what they're doing. Crafty buggers.
Well, two can play that game.
Haven't done one of these since I was at college. A little Van Dyke of tomato. 15 minutes left, yes, thank you. Thank you, Ainsley.
Coriander in. Please come out the same colour as Rasheen.
Shit, a little bit salty.
Shit.
It's got to stay green.
Okay, sesame seed paste in.
4 minutes, you have to come to the presentation table. The countdown begins.
Yep.
I've never been so much in this shit in all my life, you know that.
Stop, please.
Shit. Shit.
Man. All the participants, please go and take your seats. The judges will taste your food and give their marks. First runner-up, Mr. Gordon!
Yes!
Yes!
Oh! Runner-up, or did I win?
Oh,
shit, it's only number two, it's not one.
Yes.
OK, well, you've got to be grateful. Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you,
Richard.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you,
Ben. The winner sees none other than tag number 14, Ilima Goswami.
Woo!
Ilima Goswami!
Congratulations, what was the dish?
It was chicken.
Chicken again?
Yeah.
Damn, what did she do to the chicken that I didn't do?
Papaya and carrot.
Papaya with chicken?
Yeah, and carrot.
Excellent.
To give you
a Panasonic pressure cooker. Yahoo! Yes! I love you all! Thank you. I don't like coming second best.
Okay.
Next year, I'm coming back. Oh, yes. Number one.
Yeah.
Thank you. Papaya and chicken. That sounds interesting, that, doesn't it? Yeah? And, I mean, OK, I didn't win, fine, but what I did come here for was to pick up some knowledge to see how I can put that in to the streets of Calcutta. Thank you, ladies. Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye now. Get me to the airport. Quickly.
1 week ago, I set off on an adventure into the wilds of the northeast of India to track down the fabulous dishes that are unique to this region.
The northeast is very special and it's sort of the opposite to what I expected.
I've discovered that the food is completely different to any of the Indian classics I've cooked before.
Yeah, there's no garam masala. You know, there's no powders. It's all fresh, fragrant, very little spice.
Now I've flown back to Calcutta, where I'm about to put my neck on the line. Northeastern curries have never been sold on these streets before. I'm going to use everything I've learned to create dishes that will show this city what it's been missing. It's the crack of dawn. And I'm up early to join the other street cooks already preparing for a busy lunch.
D-Day. Now the street's starting to get busy. Everyone's starting to sort of get themselves organized. And there's a really nice smell already, so the heat is on.
With over 135,000 stalls, my competition is going to be tough. My Northeast curries need to be good enough to tempt customers away from their tried and tested favourites.
They wouldn't have seen or discovered food like this before, so I just hope in the hell that they don't turn their nose up against it because they don't recognise, oh, that's not sort of what we're used to.
And I've hired some local lads to help me out.
How are you?
Fine, sir.
Good to see you.
17, sir.
Excellent. And this is?
And it's Ayo.
Ayo. Yeah. Tapan and Ayo.
Yeah.
Sagu.
Zagat.
Zagat. Are you sure they're not bunking off school?
No.
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 Definitely.
He's not. I didn't allow him.
Okay, right.
But he's out or not.
Okay. First thing, yeah, I need the fire lighting.
Yeah.
I'm going to draw on the unique flavours of the Northeast to create three delicious curries. My first is chicken and green papaya, inspired by the winning recipe at the cooking competition. It will have that classic Assamese sour tang that the locals won't be used to.
Green papaya helps it not just soften the chicken, but marinate it, but also gives that really nice tart flavour.
Smell? So tricky.
I'm going to make a fish curry using the dried bamboo shoot from Nagaland. It's something of an acquired taste, and I don't know how it will go down here.
There's a combination of a sort of bay leaf stroke lemongrass with a little hint of licorice. First time for you. I'm so pleased.
My final dish is a northeastern take on vegetable curry. Instead of using dried spices, I'm using fresh ones, making it a more subtle flavour.
Finish with a puree of sesame seeds. Almost thicken the vegetable curry with a sesame seed paste. And then, after that, the fresh coriander paste.
Just one last thing to do before I open my stall.
I am sweating like a pig. I look like a pig. I stink like a pig. Right, I'm gonna get changed. Right, cooler, much better. So it's not exactly Chef White's, is it? But I suppose it's equivalent. A local Chef White's, I'll tell you what, it's a lot cooler. Huh? Nothing wrong with going commando in the midday sun.
Time to see if my take on the Northeast curries can win over Calcutta's foodies.
Excellent! You must stress that it's from the Northeast.
Yeah.
You must tell them that.
That's like
tell me how it's said.
Ashamiya khabar.
Ashamiya khabar.
Ashamiya khabar. Harfara,
unake
hamudan diye.
Line up, line up. Here we go. Who's first? Chicken. One.
Well done.
Good. First one up. Good. Thank you.
Chicken rice.
Chicken rice coming now. Let's go. Fish curry. Certainly, sir.
Actually, this is a new thing to us in Calcutta. I don't know other people will like it or not, but in my opinion, it's really a super one.
Let's go, let's go, let's go!
The food is very good. And I had the fish with bamboo shoots. It's very tasty.
Bamboo. Cooked. With green papaya, thank you. Let's go! Chicken papaya has gone down a storm. Extraordinary.
It was really good. I never tasted a bamboo dish before. And the vegetables and these are really good.
Last chicken!
Last plate!
Last plate! That is unbelievable. That's barely, well, 50 minutes. And over 100 portions of chicken is gone, which is fantastic news.
With the last of the chicken papaya gone, my fish and vegetable curries quickly sell out too.
Sir, thank you. That is now officially Gordon Ramsay's Calcutta Cafe closed. Finished!
It's been a great day. I've enjoyed myself, and judging by the reaction, my curry has been a success.
500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000.
2,000.
So 2,750.
Yeah.
Yahoo! That, my son, is a good morning's work.
Okay.
Yes.
Time. Every people say the yes. food is excellent.
Did they?
Yeah, definitely. Everybody said that.
But there's one person's opinion that really matters. Food writer Nandon's arrived to give me his verdict.
Hi, Gordon. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. How was your week?
My week has been amazing.
So what did you cook up today?
So today we did a take on a chicken with green papaya. We did an amazing fish curry. I saved you a little portion because I was getting slightly worried.
No wonder you sold out.
Thank you.
Believe me.
You happy with that?
Not only that, you have actually succeeded in doing something many people would have said is impossible. Well done.
That's very kind.
Very well done.
Excellent.
Very well done.
I look ridiculous, and I must have lost half my body weight in sweat. But I've proved that curries of the northeast of India are worth shouting about.
I thought my first week in India was an eye-opener. This one was a shock, I think, because it's hard to believe that exists. It's almost like you weren't in India. The culture is equally as exciting as the food. Just an amazing eye-opener, the simplicity, the concentration of the great ingredients, and not pissing around with it. India's helped me to become, you know, not just, you know, a proper chef. I was never out of that bracket, but it's helped me to confirm what I love doing more than anything. Can we top that? I doubt it, but I can't fucking wait to try.
You will cry like a baby.
What are you trying to do, kill me?
My God, that's a proper guru.
Now, they're not vegetarian, are they? I'm surprised you're so friendly with it.
First time I've ever gone 2 days without any form of meat or fish.
Yeah, here we go!
Dangerous! Fucking mad! Mad!
See that tomorrow evening at 9. And Ford's Indian winter season continues on Thursday with the struggle to survive on the streets. A dispatch's special checks out the slumdog children of Mumbai at 9. It's True Stories over on More 4 tonight. Find out why there are cowboys in India. That's just about to start. Here on 4, though, it's Celebrity Big Brother next.